Verein zwei weitere Legenden wartet. Auf ihren Einsatz ist dann als nächstes ein Spieler vorstellen, der einen bekannten Namen trägt, vor allem auch in der Schweiz. Während seiner aktiven Zeit hat er bis auf die Weltrangliste Position 24 geschafft, so im Oktober 2004. Mit der italienischen Nationalmannschaft hat er 2009 und 2011 an Weltmeisterschaften sowie insgesamt an mehreren Europameisterschaften teilgenommen. Er ist lang die unangefochtene italienische Nummer 1 und spielt heute noch in verschiedenen Ligen, unter anderem auch in der Schweiz. Er war langjähriger Spielertrainer bei Vaduz. Er ist der erste Italiener, der das ausländische Turnier beginnen und hat gegen den Gegner, den er heute spielen darf, auch ein paar interessante Fights auf der Tour, werden wir später noch etwas dazu hören. Heute ist er mittlerweile 41. 2012 hat er seine Karriere nach insgesamt 12 Titeln beendet. Bitte begrüßen Sie ganz herzlich den Davide Bianchetti!
Called my friends and said, yeah, you need to come over, you know, I don't need that visa support, so that's why.
And you could definitely hear that. Now, you're the youngest of our legends in the Legends draw, so that draw should be a piece of cake for you.
Yeah, I feel the oldest, that's possibly the biggest problem. But yeah, we'll see. I mean, everybody knows the other players, so they know how to play squash, even if they're a bit older.
Probably, yeah, and we are looking forward to that match. And das bringt uns zu seinem heutigen Gegner. Ja, und er ist eine wahre Legende, living legend of the sport. Er ist ein ehemaliger Weltnummer 1, ein weiterer ehemaliger Weltmeister. Er hat in seiner schillernden Karriere unter anderem zweimal British Open gewonnen, sagenhafte 4 Goldmedaillen an Commonwealth Games können erringen und ist deswegen zu Recht als einer von den most outstanding international squash players of his time bezeichnet wurde. Er ist Träger vom Most Excellent Order of the British Empire, das wegen seiner zahlreichen Erfolg. Er hat zuerst für die schottische Flagge gespielt und ist dann gewechselt. Seit 2001 hat er dann unter englischer Flagge seine Turniere bestritten. Heute ist er 44, ich habe es gesagt, Weltnummer 1 und das wären sage und schreibe 60 Monate. 2006 hat er seine Karriere beendet nach über 52 Titeln bei nur im Verhältnis weniger 69 Final Appearance. Meine Damen und Herren, please make some noise for the great Peter Nicol! Peter, thank you so much for joining. Or should I say, danke, dass du hier bist, weil du sprichst ausgezeichnet Deutsch.
Meine Mutter war Deutsch, so ich muss ein bisschen Deutsch sprechen, aber nur Hochdeutsch.
Ja, das verstehen wir ja. Was hast du denn Leuten zu sagen, die hier heute gekommen sind, um dieses Showmatch zu sehen?
Noch einmal?
Was hast du den Leuten, what do you say to the crowd coming today and watching your showmatch here?
Vielen Dank.
And thank you, Peter Nicol and Davide Bianchetti, the stage is yours. Marketing und Kommunikationsabteilung. Ja, das ist nicht so krass. Ich glaube, beide sind so richtig genau wie fantastisch. Ich bin Zuschauer, was das Stadion ist, was man sagt.
Ich bin ein bisschen voll von Glücks. Es sind Glücks, Leben, Menschen da. Wir sind vorne.
Ja, ich glaube, das haben auch die Schiene auch gemerkt. Das Spiel sind ja viele Leute involviert in der Organisation. Jetzt weiß ich, jetzt ist es für ein viel noch größeres Organisationskomitee zusammen. Das ist im Bereich Marketing zuständig. Was kann man uns lernen von uns berichten?
May I get some light on the stage? Grand Slam of Cup 2018 Legends Draw semi-final match. Peter Nicol of England to serve David Iannacchetti. of Italy to receive. Best of three games.
Do you want to serve?
No, I'll serve.
Lavo. Left of two. Three. Love.
So, left ball.
Left box.
Spot.
1-3. Thank you. Hand out for 1. For 1. And now, 2-5. Two five. And now, 6-3. Light box. Sorry, correction. Handout, 7-4.
Red box.
Sure?
My choice.
Okay.
Maybe
7-4.
Actually left.
No.
I just write it down.
Bravo.
7-4. And out, 5-7. And out, 8-5. Thank you. 9-5. Well done, and well done.
You're right.
Thank you. And 6-9. And now, 10-7, game ball. Oh. 11-7, game to Nicole. Nicole leads 1-0. Time. One game to love. Okay. La ball. one love. And out. One, two.
You are.
And out. Three, one.
You just said something nice about me, it's okay. 6-1?
3-1.
6-4-6.
Sorry?
6-1? 4-6.
No, 3-1.
Not close.
You want to know again? 3-1.
Wait. I'm still thinking.
3-1. And out. 2-3. And out. 4-2. Down. 5-2. And down. 3-5.
How's that?
No pressure.
4-5. Thank you. 5 all. Should I help?
Please.
Coffee of it, please.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Five all, left off.
Davide!
And now, 6-5. Seven, five. Left box, please. Thank you. Seven, five. Eight, five. And now, 6-9. And now, 10-7, match ball. Thank you. 11-8, Matthew Nicol. Nicol wins 2 games to love, 11-7, 11-8.
Ladies and gentlemen, a grosser applaus for the target young lady of the future, Nicol.
After you. You can sit afterwards, Davide, you can sit afterwards. Thanks so much for joining. What an amazing crowd, Peter. I start off with you first. It's a bit unfair of you, though, not to say harsh. You know that Davide has been playing for many years Swiss League and many fans in the audience, and you make him force leaving without having won a game.
I'm so sorry. It's the first time I've beaten Davide, so I'm really happy. Davide is the only person on the tour I have a losing record to, so that was one for, yeah. Revenge is best served very cold. So now listen, you're a great crowd. This is so much fun to come back and play. It's kind of surreal being back on the glass court and running around and playing in front of such a big crowd after years of retirement, so. Hope you enjoy the rest of this evening, and then tomorrow, we love being here. It's the first time at this event for me, and the organizers do a great job. You're wonderful. The microphone's following me around. So enjoy the rest of your evening. Thank you.
It's an honor having you, Peter. It's an honor. Davide, to you. Thank you so much for joining as well. You retired a while ago, but you're still playing some matches, Swiss League, for example, and obviously you're into coaching.
I like to play leagues and matches here and there because I still enjoy the competitive side of the game. When it's not too much, you know, once every week, a good match, it's a nice workout, all good. 1, 2, 3 matches in 2 days, no, not that much anymore.
Not anymore. But Peter, you focused after a career with, I mean, your Palmeiras is second to none, and you start focused on promoting the sport, and you also went into coaching. You founded your own academy, Nicol Champions Academy, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah. And we've seen so many good players, and can you tell us from the forefront of the juniors, how are the talented players doing at the moment?
Well, I was on with a couple of Swiss juniors this morning, and their skills, their movement, their tactics are all really spot on. They're fantastic squash players. Just need a little bit extra, but the base is there. You have fantastic coaches here in this country. The players I saw are basically just need a couple, 5-10 more percent, and they're going to be at the very top in the world. Obviously, you have your Nicky Muller, but I'm talking about the next one, the juniors. So there's great juniors everywhere, and it's just a case of if they really want to do it and they want to come through, they can. And it's Switzerland's no different. So I think there's a bright future here for squash in the next 5 to 10 years, seeing the juniors I saw.
Well, that's great to hear from a legend like you. Davide, back to you. You train and coach, obviously, in Vaduz. Have you found the new Nicky Muller yet?
Not yet, no. It's actually quite difficult to find the next Nicky Muller because the kid is very talented, a bit crazy the way I like. Plays a very spectacular and good squash, and you know it's not that easy. Even though Peter says that obviously there are players, it depends a lot on how you work with them and with the good system that surely he knows how to do it. But maybe players of the talent of Nicky, they don't actually come every generation or every now and then. It's a bit of an exception also.
Both living legends of the sport. Thank you so much for joining. We'll see you both tomorrow. Ladies and gentlemen, please make some noise for Peter Nicol and Davide Bianchetti.
It's a brand new venue for the Grasshopper Cup 2018. Come with me, we're going to check it out. We're in the retail village now, so a very, very tidy setup. All the main brands that are displaying here at the tournament, so all the fans get to see the product straight away as they enter. And oh, that's nice timing. Over here we've got Steve Buckley, who is the main man. He's the main man in a lot of different ways, but he's the main man behind this event. Steve, great to see you.
Good to see you, Joey.
Nice and early, freshly shaved and everything else.
Yeah, for you, yeah.
Well, not for me, no, but it's new venue. Obviously, yep. This has gone from strength to strength, this event. You've got to be over the moon. One with the setup, the convenience for the players, but also what's been happening in the event so far.
It's great. The quarterfinals were really great yesterday. We enjoyed it very much, and all the spectators were very, very happy.
Steve, you work a lot with volunteers. I mean, the majority of everyone that's here is a volunteer. How many have you got in total? Have you got a rough guide?
About 50 people. 50 people, and there are usually about 30 people in here every evening helping us.
And these people give up their time, they book holidays off of their work to come and help for this event.
Yeah, and we're very grateful. It's really great to work together with volunteers.
Yeah, it's fantastic. Steve, well, best of luck again tonight. I hope you enjoy the squash and obviously with all the hosting you're doing with the sponsors, and fantastic to be here again.
Thank you, Joe.
Have a good day.
Thanks.
We're going to have a look at the glass court now, which is another fantastic setup. So it's all very, very cushy. This chap is standing guard, making sure that nobody's up to any funny stuff. This guy has got a very, very good physique. Well, here we are, fantastic glass court displayed, 550 people seated for tonight's semi-finals, and we have got Mr. Wilstrop, who's practicing after his epic battle against Kareem Abdul-Gawad, 3-2-5, unbelievable for the 34-year-old. We're going to have a little watch of his practice, and then I'm going to catch up with the marksman behind the scenes after he's finished. Just grabbed him off of the court. It's hard to get to you, James.
Is it?
It is. We've been waiting quite a long period of time, and I've just explained to some of the viewers, obviously, we're giving a bit more of insight into the players, and obviously you're very polite and stuff, but there is that diva side of you. I could see you avoiding so many.
Avoiding you, Joey. I would never avoid you. not my favourite commentator, no. I know.
I want to talk a little bit about that last night. So, you played Surab first round. I personally thought you were moving a little bit slower than you would like to.
Okay.
You had to sharpen up to get through. But whatever reasons, last night you were unbelievably sharp. But
right.
Mega gutsy. Were you in a lot of discomfort? Be honest.
No, I wasn't actually that bad. I mean, I've been a lot worse,
sure.
As you like, pointed out oftentimes, puffing and puffing. Physically, I felt quite good, to be honest. Last night, there was some difficult times, obviously, and we had some hard rallies, but I was really pleased, just sort of cardiovascularly, how it came together a little bit.
Yeah.
And I didn't feel like, I was falling over at the end, so. Yeah. After a match like that, it's quite nice to know. And just recently, there's been a little bit of momentum. I mean, I really enjoyed last week. Wharf was really sharpening.
Yeah.
I mean, the intensity was ridiculous out there.
Yeah.
So I don't know. It maybe helps to have just had those games, and then suddenly you build some momentum, and then you can play at that intensity again for five games against a top eight player that hasn't been there for a while. Maybe.
Yeah.
But I'm very hungry to be on a squash court and to enjoy atmospheres like this. I mean, this is brilliant to play in front of, and having rallies like last night where
I've
seen the rally and I loved, the commentary makes it unbelievable, and it's lovely to be a part of that. I mean, I really love that, that people are retweeting it, and it's good for me and Kareem to unlike the same with Paul Cole, and those rallies just almost surpass what you achieve. They're wonderful, and
surpass the sport.
Yeah, and your excitement as to that. I thought it was tremendous.
It's a pleasure to commentate.
Nice
on
to be a part
it's
of all that.
To commentate on
this was unusual five or 10 years ago for 34, 35 year olds, Nick, 37 year olds playing the game of squash at this level. So you can't ever take it for granted.
Yeah.
This wasn't, like I say, it wasn't happening. People were retiring a lot younger, so it's good that we can all get together and play again in big semi-finals, really.
Well, I hope we, you know, all the fans obviously, we really hope your body's in good order and you're at marksman-like accuracy tonight against the Beast.
She'll try, yeah, I'll do all I can today and get the exercises done. And
I'm sure you will. We won't keep you any longer.
No worries.
Best of luck tonight, and you must be hungry. I've got a bit of lunch for you. This is a bit of lunch for James. Okay, so there we go.
The vegan's lunch, right?
He's got the bulbs there, which are very nutritious. Good protein actually in those bulbs. So James, you can devour that, and hopefully we'll see you through
some good
this
iron.
Evening.
Yeah. Share it with Nathan.
Yeah. Now we're going to check out where the big spenders hang out for the tournament. Very, very good quad workout this. You can always maximise on the training facilities of a squash tour. Well, the Swiss leave nothing to chance. Everything's on tap here for the players. There's some lovely lavender for James to dine on. He's actually been already stripping this one back. This happened yesterday. Well, what a view for the very few. All the VIPs at the moment, well, a few of them are battling out on the squash court, having a good sweat and a bit of exercise before they enjoy the what's on tap here at the VIP area, but fantastic. Wonderful setup, really, really good. Well, this is where the action's going to be tonight. Join us on Squash TV and Eurosport Player, 4:30 local time here in Zurich for the semi-finals of the Grasshopper Cup 2018.